good evening, jammers, and welcome to the Jams and Cocktails radio program. I am your host, Brad Brock, and we're live here in the legendary JNC Lounge. Man, my background looks awful blue. I'm not sure what's going on there. Did I forget something? Probably. Oh, changed. Anyway. I don't know. I'm like running on weird cylinders today because I ran out of time. So I always feel that now I feel like I'm behind on everything. But we've got quite a show for you tonight. At any rate, as we travel back in time to what is perhaps not so long ago, but could feel like a lifetime ago. Not to confuse you, but we're going to reminisce about my very first debut album, Welcome to Hollywood. It was released all the way back in 2009. Can you believe it?
Whoa. How many years ago was 2009?
14 years ago.
Sweet.
A whole teenager. Yeah.
Brad, are you going to put the 2009 filter on us?
I wish filters have caught up to computers. You know, like, I don't understand why filters only work on the apps and on your phones and not on computers. I don't know. I feel like
there's got to be filters somewhere for computers. There's got to be something.
I'm sure there is, but like to make them live like
you think there's not people on like TikTok Live or something that isn't using,
I don't know,
a real-time filter?
Oh, I'm
there's
sure.
There's real-time filters for sure.
Well, let me tell you what wasn't going on in 2009.
Real-time filters.
It was none of that. None of that was going on. You guys, you've already seen them in the round here. They're going to help me possibly console me through this trip down memory lane.
Oh, hell no.
Yeah, JNC Destruction Crew, Ms. Jordan Taylor. This is Jordan Taylor. Derek Zugel and the bad bitch, Ms. Elly Brock. Looking very... very 2000, early 2000s tonight. I like it. I like those glasses too.
I'm a little Barbie, a little Oppenheimer.
Yeah, you are Oppen Barbie or Barbenheimer, whatever they were calling
whatever.
That. Something like that.
Any and all.
Also tonight on the show, you're going to get this week's entertainment news headlines in the Jordy Files. I'm going to play a round of Name That Tune with all of you tuning in, and including the Destruction Crew here in the legendary JNC Lounge. You're going to get your midweek motivation, your bad bitch Bible study there with Elly. And of course, we'll have some music sprinkled in there for you throughout the evening. So thank you so much for tuning in live with us tonight. Please remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on social media if you're not doing so already. We are watching the chats and comments this evening, so please join our conversation. And we'd love to hear your 2009 stories, so feel free to drop any of that, or if any of the things that I mentioned tonight hit on any nerves. What did you do, Jordan? Did you throw something at Derek?
I drew a middle finger.
Art class.
I flicked him off.
Art class.
Art. Artistically, I flicked him off.
Oh, my God.
Not to be confused with.
Oh, is that what that was? I couldn't tell. It looked more like a hippo.
It kind of looked like a turkey. It wasn't great.
This is going well.
Anyways.
Well, before we hop into our time machine.
You asked.
I did. Let's get it started with our shot of the week. A shot this time, you guys. That's accepting you to cocktails this evening. All right. Our shot of the week, keeping in theme with a Welcome to Hollywood theme. This is the Hollywood shot. Super, super easy. Combine equal parts vodka, razzmatazz, and cranberry juice in a tumbler. You shake it in ice and you strain it into a shot glass or a rocks glass, as we've done here. And it looks a little something like this.
I thought it was supposed to be a cocktail.
Yeah. If you add ice, it probably would amount up to a cocktail there. Well, it's very dark, but I guess it's supposed to be.
It smells okay.
It smells awful.
Oh.
It smells very sweet. I feel like this is going to be very sweet. I'm hoping that the cranberry kind of cuts that sweetness. Anyway, cheers, you guys. Nice to have you all together.
Salud.
Cheers to all of you out there tuning in with us.
Oh, yeah, that's not...
Not terrible.
It's not my favorite.
Very sweet. It's got a very sweet.
It tastes like syrup.
Yeah. It does kind of taste. I mean, razzmatazz does kind of have that syrupy.
It's that Denny's taste. Raspberry syrup.
That's kind of what it is. Or IHOP.
IHOP.
Where they have
Denny's
all the different.
Have it anymore.
They have all the different syrups there on the table for you to use.
Drizzles.
That's all the drizzle. Speaking of. I would probably never drink that again.
No.
Oh. Or I would maybe put a little bit more cranberry in it to kind of cut that sweetness.
It's got a Jaeger aftertaste.
Yes.
Yeah.
It reminded me of Jaeger.
Yeah, it does. It even has like a Jaeger texture. Like, you know, kind of like a...
Thickness.
Yeah, the thickness. Yes, Jordan, the thickness. Yeah, well, it wasn't terrible. We've had a much had worse
worse
this season.
We've had much worse.
But, join us each week for our shot or cocktail of the week by visiting us at jnclive.tv to see what we're planning, and then click on the Drizzly link to get everything you need delivered to your door.
Drizzly!
Thank you.
You didn't say...
I know.
You
I
didn't
changed,
say it the right way, so it got me off track.
I'm sorry. You haven't been here in a while.
Why
and
did you switch it up?
Yeah.
Yeah, why are you being a dick?
Because the truth is...
the one thing away from
I'm
me.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, and then I had to awkwardly try to say it.
The truth is, reading it just doesn't... Or even saying it out loud the way I was saying it before just doesn't make sense. It made sense. It just didn't feel right.
Have to end on Drizzly.
I mean, you could still end it on Drizzly. I don't know.
Drizzly.
You have to end it on Drizzly. Then I follow up with Drizzly.
I mean, why can't...
How it works.
I mean, I could finish the sentence and then you could say Drizzly, right?
Where it's over. It's gone.
Moment
it's
done. Has passed.
Okay.
Moving Till on. Next week.
P.S. I fixed the buttons on my keyboard, so now I know where you guys are.
Good job. Only took...
It only took
8 weeks.
How 8 weeks. It probably took 8 years at this rate.
And until Derek and I switch seats next week.
Oh, God.
Oh,
yeah.
God. Yeah, you're really going to throw me off. Well, the way I have it on my keyboard here is how it goes around the room. So from where I'm sitting and then moves around, which is helpful. It was not like that before. And I don't know why. I'm an idiot. That's basically what that comes down to.
As long as you learn.
Well, none of that. None of that. Before we get into the thick of it, I just wanted to mention something that I found out today. Trop Rock extraordinaire and a guest of ours here on the JNC show, John McDonald. I'm still like trying to swallow that shot. John McDonald reached out to me today. I was just at his CD release party for Worry Less, Beach More. This weekend, and it was wonderful. He really put on a great show and had a really nice event for a CD release, and he's just a wild man. He's such a great dude, and we had a great time. So he reached out to me today to let me know that Jams and Cocktails, because we are being broadcast on Shore Life Radio simultaneously. So all of you Shore Life Radio listeners, thank you for tuning in. We were on the preliminary ballot for the Trop Rock Music Association Awards. So we are on the, everybody's voting to get the show on the ballot for the actual, you know, for the nomination. So I thought that was very cool. We've been pre-nominated for the nomination for the possible award.
Get the heck out of here.
How does the voting work?
So,
can we vote?
Yes, everyone can vote, but you have to be a member of the TRMA. Right.
Oh.
So, So you have to be a Trop Rock Music Association member. It's $15 for the year. And, so if you're already a member out there listening, we hope that we get your vote. That would be super cool of you. The ballots went out, I think, today. But then if you join, you could just, email them and ask for it and you get it. And those of you that are hardcore and just want to see us win something,
that's me.
$15. You can go and, go and check it out, Trop Rock Music Association, and join up, and then you'll find the Wednesday night live with Jams and Cocktails on the ballot. I think that's very fun. It's very fun that we've been even put on anything. Don't make me show it. Show the camera. What are you writing?
We're writing notes.
Oh my God. See, this is what it's come
I
down
got
to.
Notes. Here, show it.
Oh God. All right. We're still on that. What did Elly say?
Oh, I was asking how they got different colors. I just have the black marker.
I got new markers with all different colors.
That's fine. I'll take the black, but I want pink next time when I'm in all pink. Oh, what other ones we got?
There's so many colors. All right. Well, you look through that. So, yeah.
That is
so
cool, though.
This one's
right.
Nice.
Yeah, it's very cool. I'm very excited. And hopefully we'll... It's just nice to even be recognized at all. So I have to throw a big thanks out to Millie Marie Taylor from Shore Life Radio for allowing us to invade her airwaves for a couple hours on a Wednesday night, and for being such a great force in the trop rock world. I think we're going to have John McDonald on the show here coming up in a little bit, in the next couple of weeks, to talk about his new album and what he's got going on. So I can't believe it's been almost a year since he's been on the show. Unbelievable.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Isn't that crazy? Shy of a couple of months, he was on the show. So the time flies when you're having fun.
Time is not real.
I know. It's not real. I mean, don't ask my hair. It'll tell you it is. But also, while researching tonight's episode, I was reminded of my own possible Ed Sheeran lawsuit moment that could happen with me and the amazing Taj Mahal.
Taj Mahal.
Way to call yourself out, Brad.
I know, but I was... You know, going through all kinds of things and realize that this is something that could happen to me, because let me tell you a story. The title track on the album that we're going to be talking about this evening, Welcome to Hollywood, has a pretty distinct intro, nice drum roll into the song, and then, you know, three chords in the truth. I was setting up at a gig recently in the last 6 months or so and heard a song come on the jukebox, and it sounded just like the intro to Welcome to Hollywood. And I was like, what the hell is going on here? So I Shazammed it to see what was going on and see if I'd been ripped off and then I could go and sue somebody. Well, it was Taj Mahal, and the song came out in the 1960s, long before I had written Welcome to Hollywood, long before I was born. But I had never heard the song before that moment.
Are you sure?
I am 100% sure.
Liar.
So I'm going to let you guys tell me what you think. If Taj Mahal were to come after me for Welcome to Hollywood, would he have a case? Okay. And all of you listening out there and watching live on YouTube, throw in your comments too, because I want to know. I want to know, do they have a case? All right, are you guys ready? I'm going to give you the intro to my song, Welcome to Hollywood, first, and then we'll do Taj's, all right? Are we ready? Here we go. All right, I'm going to play it one more time for you. Thank you, Catherine. Obvious. This is Taj Mahal's Further On Down the Road.
I agree with Paul from Drums and Rums. Don't sue Brad, he ain't got
Yeah, I don't have anything to give you, Taj. Taj Mahal, a quick story. If you've listened to the show before, you know the story. But I did two wonderful cruises with Taj Mahal for a blues cruise, and we became pretty good friends. I don't call him every day, but we had several breakfasts together, and just a wonderful, lovely man. And yeah, so it's amazing that great minds think alike, clearly. So, Elly, tell me, what would do you think that he would have a case if he brought it against me?
I think it's similar, but I don't think it's the same.
Well, it's not the same.
Right.
Sure.
I don't think he has a case.
What about you, Derek?
I don't think there's a case. It's close, but no cigar.
What about you, Jordy?
Sue away.
Oh, we do want to hear what you guys think out there.
Paul says he doesn't hear it either.
And Jaybird says, meh, kind of close.
Okay, so I'm good. I'm in the clear. Jesse over on Facebook said, nope, they shouldn't because there's enough of a difference. They're very similar, but not fully alike.
Yeah.
Or at least I can hear the difference. Good, okay. So, yeah, it blew my mind when I heard it. I was like,
sue the drummer.
Sue the drummer, yeah. Who said that?
Paul. Go figure.
It would be Paul to say that. Nice. We might actually have a little interruption by Paul via Skype. Apparently, our good friend Kevin McLoughlin is playing down at Double Roads Tavern in Jupiter tonight, and Paul's going to go and crash the show.
Nice.
And I think he's going to do some remote anchoring. What do they call that? When a news
live
person
goes
on
location.
Yeah, live on location. Correspondent.
Yeah.
Yes.
Big word.
There we go. So yeah, I think after we get through all of our.
Speaking of the Kevin McLoughlin, have you guys been voting daily?
Yes, absolutely.
All right, me too. Yeah,
there's so many of my friends that are involved in that the opening act thing that's been going on. I'm gonna be real with you. It's the biggest sham in all the world. My God. They got to be raking in the dough.
Thanks, bro.
Oh, just pay a few dollars for extra votes for your favorite person. Where's that money going? That's where I want to know.
I paid a couple bucks.
Better be going to charity, lining somebody's pockets, mega yacht. But I am interested to see. I did not join this, so I can be angry about it. I hope one of our people get the spot, definitely Kevin. But if anybody does, and I need them to report back. What's it all about? All right. Well, now that we've gotten through all that,
if Kevin gets in, we have to go and see him.
Yeah,
New York.
Oh God, that's how we get to New York, isn't it? Yep. That's how we do it.
Yep.
All right. Well, good. Thank you guys for clearing that up. I love Taj Mahal. I would never rip him off. But it's good to know that great minds think alike. And the song is similar, but not the same. There we go. Now we move into the big show.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah. You guys, the year is 2009. I am 24 years old. Same age as Sweet Savannah.
Is now.
Is currently.
Sweet,
right now.
Sweet Savannah. How old are we all at this point? Let's set the mood.
Yeah, how old would you be, Jordan?
I would have been 19.
Oh, man.
Not even old enough to legally drink.
What about you, God Eleanor bless. Roosevelt?
I'd be 21.
All right.
Good for you.
Good year. What about you, Derelik?
25.
Yeah, 1 year older than me.
Oh,
25, 24,
babies.
19, and
a quarter of a century.
And 21. All right, so I have some things to show you.
No.
Yes.
Oh God.
All right. Here we go. First thing to show you.
Did you look up MySpace stuff?
Yeah, is this photos of us?
You all should know by now that I am
the ultimate creep.
And the ultimate creep, the biggest sleuth. So,
oh no!
All right, you guys, this is me in 2009. Are you ready?
Oh God!
Oh God!
I'm not ready.
It's gonna be so dark.
Oh, oh wow!
Ew!
So edgy. Look at your necklace.
Yes.
Are you high?
Maybe
every day. All day, every day.
Oh, that's, every day.
That's me.
I don't even remember the beanie phase for Brad.
Yeah, there was one, for sure.
Wow.
All right.
That's scary.
Are we ready to see Elly in 2009? This is Elly.
Are we ever?
2009.
Oh, wow.
Aww.
I think you're wearing the same shirt. Look at you.
Oh, what a muffin.
Such a little thing.
God, oh, you don't even have that guitar anymore, do you?
I don't.
Oh, and you got the black bracelets on.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It was a vibe.
Those were a thing.
Wow. It was a vibe.
I think I know where she's playing there.
There she is.
Wasn't that the coffee house over there on Bayshore? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Not a huge difference, but
we still look the same.
But a baby.
Yeah.
Aww.
All right.
What is the coffee shop now?
Probably.
I think it's like a kava bar or something. Yeah, now.
Something. This is Jordan now.
Oh. Hello.
Oh, you got.
And this is everyone. Jordan in 2009. I'm kidding. This is Jordan 2009 at 19. Oh, look at those.
The hair.
Aww.
It's the bangs. We both had the emo girl hair.
Oh, yeah. You had to have the side bangs. If you did not, you were just.
Oh, wow.
You were subpar.
Oh, you're so cute.
I was in the McDonald's drive-thru at my work that I worked at the time.
Oh, boy.
Shameless plug.
Shameless plug for a job that doesn't exist anymore.
Yeah.
And
there's no way you got a picture of me.
And sweet Derek. Sweet Derek. You were.
There's no way.
Let me tell you what, buddy. Yours was difficult.
Did you have to reach out to the parentals?
Yours was difficult. I'm not sure if this lands on 2009, but it may be earlier. This has got to be within 3 years. There he is.
Oh, yes.
There he is. Wow. And I remember those glasses.
The glasses.
But I love that you still are rocking the buttoned up with the undershirt.
Well,
some things never change. Your glasses, much better these days, pal.
Some things never change. I was actually at a breast cancer awareness event.
You
That's why I'm in all
say.
Pink.
That makes sense.
That does make sense, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I think that was either 2007 or like somewhere between those years.
Yeah.
Long ago.
Yeah.
I know where I was working at the time. And I know who I was dating at the time.
Ah.
So what year was this?
It probably was 07, 06, 07. But yeah, pretty close.
There are not a lot of photos of Derek out there in the world. I would have had to have done some more digging, but I could have found them.
I don't take pictures, but obviously if you look at me, other than being a little fatter, I haven't changed much. Not even my facial hair.
Yeah, you're pretty much. I mean, I think
still
you're
got the hat on.
I think you're a vampire.
Yep.
Oh man. Well, you guys.
Crazy.
But the truth is, some of the things that went down in 2009 makes it seem not so far away, but also an eternity ago. So this is where you guys are going to let us know how it makes you feel in the chats and comments. When I'm about to list off all these things, all these events that happened in 2009, are you all ready?
No.
I don't think I am. After seeing those pictures, I don't know. Yeah.
You guys.
I can't even talk.
I can't. I'm speechless.
In 2009, Chesley Sully Sullenberger landed his airplane on the Hudson River shortly after takeoff from LaGuardia Airport in New York. All the passengers and crew members survived in what has become known as the Miracle on the Hudson. That was 2009.
Don't even remember that.
It was a great movie.
There was Tom Hanks made a movie, Sully.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah, well,
got nothing.
You were 19. Hey,
put
so.
The bong down.
Yeah. There was, got nothing.
Well, so that happened 2009.
Chesley?
Yes, Chesley. He's known as Sully.
Sully.
Oh.
Barack Obama was inaugurated as the 44th president of the United States. And becomes the U.S.'s first African-American president. 2009. Also in 2009, Blame It on the Alcohol, a single released by Jamie Foxx featuring T-Pain, was released. And it was the Billboard Song of the Year in 2009.
Wow.
Blame It on the Alcohol. Blame It on the You know the one?
Thank you.
Yeah.
What's going on with him? Is he okay now?
I don't think, T-Pain or Jamie? All
Jamie.
Of them. No, he's having some problems, but I think he's doing okay. Yeah.
Heard there were like conspiracy theories about if he's alive or not.
Yeah, no, he's all right. He's released some videos.
Have you seen him?
Yeah, I went and gave him flowers.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Also in 2009, RuPaul's Drag Race premiered.
Jordan.
Aww.
It was a big year for you.
That's so sad.
Singer Rihanna canceled. I'm sorry, Rihanna cancels performance at the Grammys after being beat up by Chris Brown.
Oh, shit.
Allegedly.
Awkward.
Mm-hmm. Here's one of my personal favorites. The gay dating site Grindr launched.
Yeah.
First ever dating app to combine dating information and location. Oh, Grindr. Mm. 2009.
Wait, why is that one your favorite?
I said one of my favorites.
It's one of his favorites because he was one of the first people on
it. It's just amazing. It was so forward thinking. Only the gays. Very innovative.
Did Grindr come out before Tinder?
Yeah, definitely.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Paving the way.
Also in 2009, the first cases of H1N1 swine flu in the United States occurred in two people in California.
That was a big thing.
You guys remember swine flu?
That was huge.
Yes. Also in this year, the CDC named swine flu a global pandemic. So how about that?
They know.
Little did they know. More importantly, though, Boom Boom Pow, released by the Black Eyed Peas, won the award for the best music video in 2010 and Billboard Song of the Year in 2009.
Or the remix.
Gotta get it.
Gotta kick cat.
Oh, God.
Gotta kick cat, boom. Cat. Boom,
boom, boom. 2009, the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame inducted Jeff Beck, Little Anthony and the Imperials, Metallica, Run DMC, Bobby Womack, Wanda Jackson, Bill Black. Wait, we know Bill Black. No, different one. DJ Fontana and Spooner Oldham. That happened in 2009. Wow. Also in 2009, Star Trek, the film reboot directed by J.J. Abrams, starring Chris Pine and Zachary Quinto, premiered in Austin, Texas.
That was
2009. Parks and Recreation, starring Amy Poehler and Nick Offerman, debuted on NBC in 2009.
Wow. That was a big year for them.
Also, the video game Minecraft is first released to the public while still in development.
Yeah.
These things are huge now. The musical show Glee, starring Jane Lynch.
I loved it.
And others, premiered on Fox. She-Wolf, the lead single from Shakira's eighth album, premiered in 2009. Also, right after that, TikTok, the single released by Kesha, was released and became Billboard Song of the Year just the next year. Unbelievable, right?
Yeah.
In 2009, British pop rock band Oasis finally called it quits. While the Walt Disney World decided to buy Marvel for $4.24 billion. And then Microsoft released Windows 7, 2009. And of course, in 2009, Brad Brock released his debut album, Welcome to Hollywood.
The biggest news.
The biggest news. So you guys, the Welcome to Hollywood record was almost a decade in the making, as it were. And it's a collection of tunes that I'd been writing since I was a teenager. It's really a hodgepodge of recordings I'd made over that whole period of time. The main chunk of it was actually recorded in my house in Orlando, where I lived with my friends, drummer Dan, Drew Patrone, and Sam Allison. Wonderful. Oh, there's Derek still. Yeah, so.
Oh.
Check
it
out. Wow.
Put it back.
And as so here on the
look
screen,
look at that chest hair.
I know, oh, it was wonderful.
Gosh.
Just so everybody knows, that's all real. And now it's gray. That's why you can't see it.
I know.
Is that the same shirt you're wearing now?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh my God.
How observant, Derek.
Well, I'm
it's
looking
in the
at
album you. Cover too.
I'm legit. I have
Is that
his
your favorite
camera.
Shirt?
I have his picture in front of me, and right above that, I see this. I'm like,
this shirt is quite
Brad, you
quite
gotta,
ancient.
You
it's a
pop,
lot tighter now.
Yeah, and you got to pop the collar. What are you doing? There you go. Get it like your photo. Come on. Oh, yeah. Yeah, look at that.
Yeah, it's very, very
stud. Where's your neck going?
Many years of being old. it's amazing. This shirt's still in the closet. It's funny.
Look at that smolder, though.
Yeah. God, what a lovely young man.
You got cheekbones.
Look at the hair. Look at the hairline. The hairline is just the most impressive thing.
It's just brush forward. Don't kid yourself.
I can't even brush this forward and make it look like that anymore.
Remember when you tried to grow it out so you could do that?
Oh, God. Yeah, and then I had a wedding.
Yeah, ruined everything.
Oh, no. So the original release in 2009 featured my face on the cover.
In the same shirt.
In the same shirt. Clearly the same photo shoot, because the hair is exactly the same. And then later on, my good friend Drew actually rebranded the whole thing for me, and we did a digital re-release with the new cover. Much better, I think. Better improvement. This doesn't have my stupid face on it. Oh, yeah. and here's the track list.
Wow. Look at that jump.
Of 11 tunes on there. It included songs Unrequited, Starlight, Come Back to Me, 11, Stealing the Covers, In a Love Song, Ring Around the Sun, The Artist, Welcome to Hollywood, of course, Parade, and Happy Birthday, but not the one that you think. Very pop rock song. But some of these tunes I still perform regularly at my shows. Here we are 14 years later.
Name one.
Unrequited, I play at almost every show. Stealing the Covers. Welcome to Hollywood happens occasionally. Yeah.
So can
11,
we,
you play a lot too.
And 11, I play a lot.
Can we vote on what song we want to hear?
Mm-hmm. No. Because the truth is, I've only prepared one, and I don't know the lyrics to almost all of them.
Wow.
Anymore. But I had some wonderful musicians perform on this record, and I started stealing their time because I lived with them. We had Sam Allison and drummer Dan Gentile on there. Sam is an amazing bass player, a Grammy Award-winning audio engineer. He's been on many, many Latin recordings since I've known him. And just a killer bass player. So he played a lot on a lot of the tunes on this. Drummer Dan, just my best friend from like grade school, not even grade school, since
the
birth.
The sandbox.
Yeah, beyond that, I don't even think the sandbox. I think it was earlier than that. So just, you know, we lived together in Orlando, and you know, always had the drums set up in the living room. So what was fun was... he performed on several of the tunes, like Unrequited and Stealing the Covers. And Dan actually had a fun little story about one of these many afternoon impromptu recording sessions. Here it is from Dan himself.
Hey, Jams and Cocktails Podcast. This is drummer Dan, lifelong friend and longtime drummer for Brad Brock. Brad and I were living together at the time. And I got home from work one afternoon to find our living room converted into a makeshift studio with my drum kit set up and mic'd, and a note saying, put the headphones on and sit down. And so I did, and a very ominous Brad Brock voice came on the line, said, good afternoon, drummer Dan. I've written some songs today, and we're going to record them. Here comes the click. And off we went and recorded what became some of the live drums on, I think, the Welcome to Hollywood album.
Yeah, and they did. And they did.
Wow.
Just how wonderful. yeah. And just so you can, you guys can see, this is actually the recording studio setup.
Oh my God.
Wow.
That I was using to record most of the tracks.
Look at that.
Wow, Brad, you really don't get rid of anything, do you?
She's like, all that's still in my garage.
Abe is still right behind us.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Right there. Yeah.
I just, things just survive.
The artwork up above. Oh, wow.
Wow, yeah.
Oh, Brad, the computer screen, we still have that computer screen, don't we?
No, that thing's gone for sure. That's not even a flat screen. It's like one of those big box computers.
The phone.
Yep, that phone.
Dear. Oh, yeah. I know where that lamp is.
Oh, yeah, I have that lamp in my office right now.
Oh,
currently.
Yeah, that too. Oh, dear.
I don't know what I was doing with two printers.
And
but
his gold album.
Yeah, the gold album.
The gold album.
the thing off to the left.
Oh, yeah. I think that thing got destroyed.
And the one
but,
above.
But I had replacements made for it, yeah. Of course. Wow. Yeah, so that was the...
epic.
That was the old studio there.
So Jaybird says, I remember when you released this, you were doing karaoke at Castleberry's patio bar right before you left us to do the cruise ship thing.
Yeah, that's absolutely right. You know, I'm gonna mention that as well. So after releasing Welcome to Hollywood, I was really able to dive into the Orlando original music scene of the time there and performed at some really great small venues like the Social Casey's Back Booth, RIP, and various other venues like the Plaza Theater, which became notoriously famous, and Wall Street down there, which has great events still going on to this day. So I really got to get into the local music culture of Orlando at the time by releasing original music, which was great. And this album was my first dive into music licensing, which is, you know, when people can license my music to use in film and television. And I got my first break with the title track, Welcome to Hollywood. I was actually amazed to find out that our favorite here on the show.
Boo.
No. I was to find out it was licensed to appear in CMT's Behind the Music episode featuring Miranda Lambert. Of course, her life up until that point, and it took a huge left turn, so now I don't get any residuals. I do think I still get like one penny a quarter for whatever reason. But yeah, this was obviously when she was still married to Blake Shelton, and that was still going on. But that was the first time that I felt a little bit of musical success.
How much was your first royalty check from that?
It was hundreds of dollars.
Oh, wow.
I think because I had been away when I checked. Mm-hmm. I had been away on the cruise ships for so long. So when I finally got back and was trying to get my effects in order and my things in order and found all my passwords, I got in there and saw hundreds of dollars in the account. They didn't know where to send the check to. And I was like, yeah, you could send it to me, baby. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I was like, and then I had to do some research. I was like, what? Who used this? Because it doesn't come right out and say what happened. And I tracked it down. I tried to find the video for it today, but I'm sure it's been disintegrated by now. She's making news for other reasons these days. And so, friends, I continue to really to perform these songs around town and grow in the scene until I ran off to join the circus, better known as the cruise ship industry. And the rest is kind of a story for another time. We'll do another show on that whole debacle. But I still play the tunes from this song, or the tunes from this album, at almost all my shows, and I love them. And, yeah.
Let me just, for those of you that have been around the Brad Brock world for quite some time, this is the first released album, not the first recorded album.
Yeah, yeah. This is the first one that I put out into the world.
Right.
Proper release.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Otherwise.
Is it on Spotify?
It is. It is. It is. And I hope you can listen to it. But this happens to be one of my favorite tunes from the album and a lot of people's favorite tunes. Guess what, guys? It's time for live music. You're on JNC. I know you don't get it very often, but I'm going to do it for you. Before I get started, this song is called 11. And it was certainly one of the more popular tunes off of the album. And the story goes, and I was playing Scrabble with the my girlfriend at the time, and the relationship was still pretty new. So we hadn't really confessed or professed our love for one another quite yet. During my turn in the game, I scored an 11, and I looked at her and said 11 so that she could write down the score. She totally misheard me and thought that I said, I love you. And
wishful thinking.
Yeah, shocking. But that became our thing throughout the course of our relationship. And this fun little song came out of it. And so this is 11. Or as I like to call it, a potty break for the rest of the crew. Here we go. She's short of a dozen, one short of a case. It's two less than a big maze when it's spinning a big cake. It's four more than seven, it's three more than eight. It's always ten to me, but that's as one can be seen or live. I love you with words just can't describe. It's going on inside. I live. I love you. So come here and say goodnight. Give me some number five. Please, baby, don't take this the wrong way. One in a million, and everyone along the way. Sometimes you come up short, but never short on me. Just remember these four words. If you ever down the way I feel, I love. When words just can't describe what's going on inside, I live. I love. So come here and say goodnight. Give me some number five. One is for fun, two is for cool, three and four is for so much more than anyone can do. Five is for your eye, six is for the night. 7, 8, and 9, and 10 are just baby steps until we get to live. I love you. When words can't describe what's going on inside. I live. I love you. So come here and say goodnight. Give me some number five. I live. I love you. Yes, I do, and words just can't describe what's going on inside. And I live. I love. So come here and say goodnight. Give me some number five. Oh, Paul is at Double Roads. Oh boy! All right, good
very
to know,
good, Brad.
We're almost through this segment, Paul. If you're still out there listening, but
did you say you were playing Scrabble?
Scrabble.
My gosh, how old were you guys? 87.
But yet he won't play Quilf.
Yeah. Like you? Did you enjoy Scrabble?
I mean, I don't know.
Oh,
I was just we play games. That's not Jordan.
He doesn't know the camera still.
we play board games and all kinds of fun stuff, you know. So I don't think it's...
That's cute. But yeah. He won't play Quilf with us.
Yeah. Mm. Well, Quilf is
in the land of the farm.
Ooh.
Terrible. Terrible game. Don't like it. Truth be told, a couple years after Welcome to Hollywood was released, I filmed a music video for the track The Artist during one of my cruise ship breaks. Actually features my adorable nephew, who is about to turn 18 in a few months. So we're going to play that for you. We'll be back with more jams and cocktails and possibly an update from Paul at Double Roads with Kevin. When we return, this is The Artist from Welcome to Hollywood. Cheers.
Thank you. you see what I see? A color portrait of you and me standing in a backyard by a tree through the eyes of the artist. He takes his brush across your face, adds a touch of beige that always fades to gray. It's a constant reminder of the price we have to pay for love. And the artist, he says, hey, add a little color to the picture. No room for a permanent fixture, 'cause everybody's changing. The world just keeps on changing. Not a lot of time left to borrow before we go turning into tomorrow. And we're all participating in constant rearranging until the artist says good night. Fear what I fear. One day you're there, and the next you're here, just wondering which way you'll have to steer through the mind of the artist. He tears his brush across his brain. Yeah, he tries to cover up all the things that cause him pain. He paints a million perfect people in a world that's plagued with shame for love. Ooh, and the artist, he says, hey, add a little color to the picture. No room for a permanent fixture, 'cause everybody's changing. The world just keeps on changing. It's not a lot of time left to borrow before we go turning into tomorrow. And we're all participating in constant rearranging until the artist says goodnight. No matter what I do, I just can't keep them apart. What was once a perfect picture is now a perfect work of art. I'm consumed by all this sadness, but there's laughter in the air when I look in the mirror. Wanna know who's standing there. Add a little color to the picture. No room for a permanent fixture, 'cause everybody's changing. The world just keeps on changing, 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 spinning me into oblivion. Oh, add a little color to the picture. No room for a permanent fixture. Everybody's changing.
There you have it there. That was The Artist, my one and only music video and all of it. That song was actually reimagined for as a bonus track for Songs About You and Every Other Girl, which was my next album there. And that record came out 4 years later. and was born a new era of music and songwriting. And but that first record will always hold a little special place in my heart. So long live, welcome
the queen.
Okay, and to Hollywood. Well, thank you, thank you.
She was talking about you anyway. Right? Yeah.
Who's ready for another sparkling edition of Name That Tune? Sparkling. Sparkling, Jordan, just like you. I'll be your sweet babe. All right. Here we are. So, as always, we invite all of our live viewers to play along with us in the chats and comments. We're looking for the name of the song and the artist or band that performs it. Tonight's category is Hollywood.
Knew it.
And you guys, you're not going to believe this. Super easy this week. It's going to be super easy.
Yeah, that's what you keep saying.
You say that every time.
I know.
He sets us up for failure.
Yeah.
What a great guy you are.
I think it's going to be fine this time. I think it's going to be fun. Oh. Kevin's back in the background. Can't hear him well, though. All right. Are we ready to play? First clue. Okay, not all at once. Jordan, Jordan, are you doing your taxes over there? Are you deleting emails? Christ. What are you doing?
Brad, I have official business to handle.
Remember when Jordan was on her phone when you were about to propose?
Yeah. How could I forget? Me and Kevin, we had to do our whole spiel over again.
Some things never change, Brad.
I'm doing official business, deleting emails.
You know they bother me.
My God.
She's organizing files. She's got to pay
your bills somehow.
Somehow.
Yeah, I got to keep on top of our life. Someone's got to do it.
All right, first clue here and name that tune. She was looking
so right. I knew it. In her
diamonds and frills. I've never heard this song, though.
Ever.
Never?
Never.
Somehow, I don't believe that at all.
I always get this just far away gaze when I play this game.
You do. You just look out into the distance.
I try to go back in the brain space. She was looking so
right. First time I ever heard this song, I was hanging out with Jordan.
Yeah.
First time?
Live.
It felt like the first time.
First time live.
That's a different song. All right. What do you guys have here in the lounge?
You got a goose egg?
What's a goose egg?
Is it Hollywood Nights?
Yeah. Oh my God, Derek.
It is Hollywood Nights by Bob Seger.
And Bob Seger.
The Silver Bullet Band.
Yeah.
And of course, Silver Bullet Band.
Sexual.
Yes. Not Big City Nights, but he does say that, Jay Bird. He does say that in the song.
And he does say Hollywood Hills.
And he does say Hollywood Hills.
Yeah.
So
very deceitful song.
A little deceitful.
Many times he says Hollywood Hills.
Yeah.
All right. Good job. Good job. What did you say, Elly?
I had nothing.
She had nothing. Okay. Oh, well, here's one that may be easier for everyone. Look to my right and I see the Hollywood
sign. This is all so crazy. Wait. Oh, what is it?
You guys, you need to brush up on your game here.
I got this.
Here it is again. Look to my right and I see the Hollywood sign. This
is all so crazy. Can I have extra credit if I tell you who it was supposed to be sung by / whose song it actually was?
Sure, that'd be fine.
Do you know?
No.
Oh.
You'd be enlightening me.
I saw it on TikTok. Has to be true.
It was Party in the USA was the answer for that one. It's a party in the USA. Get to the club in my taxi cab. Still a jam. Do you guys believe it's still a jam?
Yes.
She sounds way different now.
All right. Next clue coming at you here for Name That Tune. Diving right back in. Here we are.
I am wishing Paul a happy birthday.
Oh, good job, Derek. But nothing comes close to the Golden Coast. Here's that clue one more time. But nothing comes close to the Golden Coast. All right. I told you it's pretty easy. Everybody's writing feverishly here in the lounge. Jaybird with the correct artist. What do you guys got here in the lounge? California Girls by Katy Perry is correct. With a U. Yeah, that would be the proper way to do it. Nice. Jaybird said Cali Girls. I thought it said Call
so
Girls.
So did I.
And I was like, yeah, kind of yeah, right.
Same thing.
All right. Are we ready for the next clue here?
Yes.
So you got it, Jaybird. I'm going to give it to you, pal. All right. Next clue. Hollywood. I only call you when it's Derek
shut up.
Had the look of despair. Here it is again. I only call you when it's half-past, but he only... This song is such a jam like 19 years ago.
I'm right there with you, Jaybird.
Jaybird said, no clue. I know what it is.
Of course you do.
I dominate turd. The California category.
This is a Hollywood category, not the California.
What do you guys got? Let's see it.
It's interchangeable. Bam!
It is The Hills.
Nice, Elly.
It's really just The Hills.
Oh, is it?
It's
oh,
just The Hills. But yes, The Hills,
Have Eyes was a very
gross movie.
I actually walked out of that movie.
I watched out of this. Walked out of the second one.
They made a second one?
Worse. Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty bad. All right. Final clue of Name That Tune. Are we ready?
Ready.
Here we go. Hollywood.
Really?
Here it is again. Derek's back in it. All right. Jaybird nailed it. What do you guys got? It is Vogue by Madonna.
She got it wrong. She said Madonna.
Madonna.
Madonna Party of One.
Spelling doesn't count. I know what she meant.
It's her nickname.
Nice. Good job, you guys. Killed it.
Did you have any doubt? Where the fuck?
I mean, I did say it was the easiest category we've had in a while.
Shut your mouth when you're talking to us.
We're going to pop over to Kevin McLoughlin at Double Roads in Jupiter, and we'll be back.
Hey, y'all, we are here at Double Roads Tavern down in Jupiter, Florida, and we have a very serious... Today is a national holiday. It's the 14th anniversary of Brad Brock's first album, and we're going to go ahead and play the Brad's favorite song that we do. Love you, man. Oh, by the way... Not only do we kick out the jams here, but we drink all the cocktails.
Come on, mom.
God, those guys are amazing. Well, you guys, it's time to see what ruckus these celebrity whack jobs are creating in the world around us. This is the Jordy Files. Now for the star of the Jordy Files, Jordy.
Hello.
Hello, Jordy.
We'll see how well my producers did tonight. Oh.
I'm kidding.
Jordy Don, I'm so glad you're here.
Jordy Don Files. Welcome to the Jordy Files. I'm Jordy Don. Tonight, we will discuss.
Oh my God, are you having a stroke? Old Mitch McConnell over there. Yeah. Can't get it out of your mouth.
I was trying to improvise, but we just got to read.
That's what I've been saying since the dawn of time. Just read the script.
Fine.
So
I
easy.
I wrote it for you. Just do it.
Oh, my God. That's what I do. You think I could get through any of this show if I didn't just read?
ChatGPT did it for us.
Whatever.
No, not this. I actually have to write all this crap out.
Wow.
Ah, fool.
Yeah, I'm an idiot.
Yes. Well, we lost yet another entertainment legend. Lizzo is in some hot water. And love her or hate her, Taylor Swift is still awesome? Question mark. Here are some celebrity birthdays to start.
He made you say that.
Yeah, what a dick.
You're like Ron Burgundy. Just
I
put
quit.
It on the teleprompter.
I quit. I need a pay raise to be in these kind of conditions.
Oh, boy.
Singer Charlie XCX is 31 today. And why does she look just like Elly?
I was going to say that
Yeah.
We can see it.
That's crazy, actually.
Yeah. Interesting.
Are you Charlie XCX?
I might be.
Dun, dun, dun. Or is Charlie XCX?
When we went to Jordan's Bachelorette, when we decided to take, I don't know, a long, very long walk to another bar that was very crowded. So I literally walked a mile in my Louboutins, okay?
Mm, oh, no.
Nice.
Paige had posted up by the bar with these two very delightful but very intoxicated little gay boys. Brilliant. And they told me I look like her and like pulled up a picture and were just like losing their minds.
Yeah. Aww. I mean, it's uncanny. I wish I could do a side by side, but
I mean,
give the look.
What was her profile? Hold on.
Let's see. There it is.
Other way. Hold on.
Yeah.
I mean, the hair, the makeup, the nose, the eyeballs, everything.
Yeah.
Now, however, there are some photos that you don't look like her at all. But in this particular photo,
most of them, though.
That's far out. That's funny that somebody else caught on to that.
And I've never like really listened to her, like knew who she was. Mm. And I had to like Google it at the bar and I was like, oh, shit.
It is me. All right. What else you got there, Jordy?
Well, happy birthday, Elly.
Thanks. To be 31 again.
Yes. The good old days. Actor Sam Worthington from Avatar's 47 today.
He's been in other things, but yes.
Oh.
Just Avatar. That's the only one that's important.
And those things. Other things. And the actor and director, Kevin Smith, is 53 today.
Wow. Silent Bob is 53.
Yeah.
Yeah, buddy.
Wow.
Do you guys follow him on social media?
I do. No.
I do somewhat.
He's such a like just genuinely nice guy.
He definitely seems to be. Yeah.
Yeah. He's very grateful for his life.
Aw.
Yeah, we had quite a scare. Because this is clearly an old photograph of him, but he like lost a ton of weight.
Yeah.
But he had like, I think it was a heart attack or some sort of scare. And he was like, nope, life has changed forever now.
Yeah.
And I mean, he looks great.
It humbled him for sure. But he's always been like an all around nice dude.
Did you guys watch I guess it's a sequel to the Jay and Silent Bob movies they put out recently?
I didn't see it.
No.
If you're looking to waste some time,
it's a good way to make it. Great.
It made me laugh out loud, for real.
All right, I'll check it out. I have to revisit the Jay and Silent Bob films anyway, because they were characters, but they appeared in like Dogma, which was an incredible film, I thought, you know, like a little sacrilegious in a lot of ways, but like really kind of eye-opening anyway. And then Jay and Silent Bob, and then Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back, Mall Rats,
Clerks.
No, it wasn't Mall Rats. It was Clerks. Oh, it was both of those, wasn't it?
Yeah, they were in both of them. Yeah. Weren't they in the Waiting movies?
No, I don't think they were in that film. Maybe. But he's also a great director, too. So.
Oh, fantastic.
All right.
Good stuff.
Nice. Happy birthday.
Yeah.
Silent Bob.
Yay.
Kevin Smith. All right.
Yeah. Not to be confused with Kevin James.
No.
In that picture, almost.
Yeah.
Yeah, almost.
Funny. And I don't know if you all have heard, but the Pee Wee Herman has passed away. Actor Paul Reubens at the age of 70. I guess he passed away after a cancer diagnosis that I guess he had secretly been battling for some time on Monday. And he was 70.
It's hard to believe that he was 70.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pee Wee Herman started in the 80s?
Yes.
Oh my God, how old are we? Anyway, sorry.
I'm tired of you saying how old are we. I know.
I was 24 in 2009, if that's any inclination.
Oh, golly.
Yeah, no, sad. You know, he had his share of controversy over the years, but
He's still Pee Wee Herman.
I mean, all in all, he just, you know, he served his time or paid his debt to society and continued making art. So, I don't know.
Yeah. And then Lizzo is sued by performer dancers for assault, discrimination, and sexual and racial harassment.
Harassment.
Which is so not like Lizzo, so we thought, but who knows anyone, really? Three former dancers of singer Lizzo have filed a lawsuit against her claiming religious and racial harassment. Ooh. Disability discrimination, assault, false imprisonment, and other offenses.
Well, damn.
Oh, my. The list goes on and on. What a laundry list there. The complaints state that the dancers endured
pronounce it, Jordan.
Jeez, denigrating behavior.
Oh, denigrating behavior. Religious. I was going to. Yeah. Anyway. Religious preaching. Weight shaming. Oh. And were coerced into participating in disturbing shows. I need more details on all of this.
Well, yeah, it was very vague.
Keep reading.
Oh, okay. The lawsuit names Lizzo, her production company, and the captain of her dance team as defendants. Attorneys for the plaintiffs have criticized Lizzo's treatments for her dancers, stating that it contradicts her public image. The dancers were introduced to Lizzo while preparing for her reality TV show and working on her music video. She has a reality TV show? What?
Correct.
Okay. Oh. But one resigned from the team while the other two were fired. Some fans believe Lizzo may have addressed these allegations in her song Rumors. Certain lyrics suggest Lizzo cutting off people and facing lawsuits, which resonate with the dancer's claims. Following the news, other women came forward on social media sharing negative experiences working with Lizzo and showing support for the lawsuit. Former employee Courtney Hollenquist clarified that the allegations aligned with her own experience. Quinn Wilson, a former creative director for Lizzo, also echoed this sentiment. Sorry. Filmmaker Sophia Nahali.
Nahali.
Okay. Oh, wait. Allison. Okay, whatever her name is. Claimed she left her role as director of Lizzo's documentary due to disrespectful treatment, while the captain of Lizzo's dance team, Shirley Quigley, cute last name, posted a message of love. Lizzo herself has not publicly responded to the lawsuit. Dun, dun, dun.
Yeah, she's...
That's awkward all around and hypocritical.
I kind of feel like this might be a little house of cards. I hope it's not true because
it's like her song, Am I Ready? She better be ready.
Because so, you know, many people look up to her and her message of, you know,
you're awesome.
Yeah. Loving your body, loving your, you know, who you are, and then turn around and you find out that she's just treating everybody around her like shit and being wild. I don't know. It's doesn't seem hard to believe, but also you don't want it to be true. So I guess we'll find out. We'll follow the story.
Anything can happen in
Hollywood.
In this world.
Yeah. So, well, she's gonna learn today.
Seems like it's probably kind of hard to prove, right? I mean,
maybe. I mean,
I don't know.
Unless everybody starts coming out of the woodwork saying, yep, no, this is how she treats us.
Yeah, that's a lot of people to come forward. Like,
but isn't that the trend nowadays, too? It's like one person says it and then it's... like Jay wildfire.
Jay said it was just bad bitch o'clock.
Ah, yeah, it's thick 30.
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh Lord,
she's just ready to be loved.
She's
they want some of her money.
That's what Jay said, and maybe, but like,
and also truth hurts.
Okay.
Okay. Wow. Anyway,
We'll see. We'll follow the story. We'll keep you updated.
I'm sure there'll be more every week forever.
I hope it's not true.
I hope it's not true.
Because I like Lizzo.
Yeah, same. That would be very hypocritical, which also seems like it could be likely. Anyway, Taylor Swift pays each Eras Tour truck driver $100,000 bonus. Hmm. So, everyone.
Jordan is not impressed.
Yeah.
Yeah. She.
Why are you not impressed? I'm sorry, Philip, if you're still out there. We know that Pam hates Taylor Swift.
Yeah, as do I. I'm just kidding.
Why?
She's just annoying. Just whatever. Unnecessary, really. I mean, she's lovely. I think she's,
music.
That's what I mean. Like,
I like maybe one song, two songs at most.
Yeah, same. But I just don't get the hype around her. I mean, I think she's a lovely person, but like.
Yeah, I think she's doing the most.
Yeah, but her music's kind of trash.
Her music's kind of trash.
And the concert, like everyone's so excited and pays thousands. I'm like, I honestly probably wouldn't go even if you gave me a ticket, to be honest.
I'd go.
I'd go if someone gave me a ticket. But yeah, her seems tickets like a hassle. Are hella expensive.
Yeah.
I bet if you went, it would change your life.
Doubtful.
You'd be a Swiftie forever.
Doubtful.
Anyway, in other news, I just signed up to become a trucker. We're going to CDL school together, Jordan.
Oh, good.
Philip just said, did you hear her eye roll?
I heard it from across the country, Philip.
Mine?
No.
Oh, Pam's.
Yeah, Jay Bird said she gave out over $55 million to everyone. That's pretty cool.
Yeah,
on the
that
tour.
Is nice of her.
Like $100,000 just for driving the truck.
Yeah.
Just for showing up with pieces of her stage.
And I think she gave it to other people too. I saw in some thing. Probably
she gave bonuses to everyone.
Yeah, like her production tour. Or not production crew, but people
her
dancer.
Yeah, what did I say? It wasn't just her band members, her dancers, lighting and sound techs, other crew members. While it's not known, I guess, how much they received, it was apparently a very generous amount.
Yeah. So that was nice of her.
Yeah. And that's, you know, and now she's about to take this show overseas. That was just the first leg of her Eras tour. And so it's done in the U.S. and now it goes across the water.
Yeah. They all should do that because it's like, how much did she make from that?
Well, considering tickets were going for like $25,000, I'm sure she did all right.
Yeah. Right. I was going to say, would she rake in like a billion?
I don't know. I'm interested to see what the numbers are because we just talked about Elton John with the highest grossing tour and Ed Sheeran, of course, the highest grossing solo tour of all time. So I'm interested to see what those numbers are. It's wild. I have a hard time paying $100 for a ticket to go see somebody. And I'm like, I don't know.
Yeah. It's like down payment on a house.
It's got to be illegal somehow to have ticket prices that much money.
Well, I mean, that's why the government's like looking into Ticketmaster and that whole debacle right now. So I don't know.
And stick around, folks.
Until people stop spending the money, they're going to charge those prices.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fools.
And what were you going to say, Jordan?
Oh, and until then, stick around till next week to see what other shenanigans are going on in this world. I'm Jordy, signing out.
Wow, that was a...
She's like, I'm done.
Gotta go.
Let's get out of here.
L-Y-O.
I don't want to talk anymore about Taylor.
Yeah, that was enough. Okay. I think we gave her enough time.
Good one.
Yeah.
Good one.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was good.
All right, moving right along. Good job, Jordan.
Thank you.
Now it's time to grab a pen and paper to take some notes because it's time to get you over this midweek slump with Ellie's Bad Bitch Bible Study.
Good to be back.
Oh my God, you totally match your whole backdrop tonight.
I know.
Look at you.
Yeah, we missed you, Ellie.
Very impressed.
Never leave
I
us again.
I missed you guys too.
Sorry, Derek, we didn't miss you.
Wow.
I'm just kidding.
Sorry.
I'm kidding. No, it's nice to have you all here together.
Yeah. The gang's back together.
The family's all one.
Derek.
Yes.
What is one thing that happened to you today?
Uh-oh.
That made you happy.
Oh.
that was a good thing.
I was able to get out of work on time to come and spend some time with three of the people I enjoy spending time with the most.
Aww.
Nice.
And how did that make you feel?
Joyous.
Fantastic. Jordan.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
What is something that happened to you today that made you happy? Oh, or joyous?
That's not Jordan.
Oh. Still not Jordan. Oh, okay. Well, I did a demo today, and the customer really liked the item that we reserved for them and tested out, and it did what they wanted, and so they ended up getting it. And
so you sold a truck today?
It was some equipment, or like some accessory pieces and stuff, and a bunch of them. So
nice.
Yeah, and it did, and other companies' product couldn't do it. So we had the right tool for the job. So it was really nice. They were very happy with it, and that makes me happy.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Yeah, so it was awesome. I was like, hell yeah, we'll leave this heavy-ass shit with you so I don't got to lug it around anymore. This is great. Perfect. But yeah.
Nice.
So made their day. Made my day.
Fantastic. Bradley.
Yes.
Same question.
Well, before I answer, Jaybird answered. He said, just this podcast for me. The rest of the day kind of sucked.
Aww.
Right there with you, Jaybird.
Shucks.
Love you, Jaybird. Glad we could be here. Let me think carefully about all this.
Wow.
Yeah, you have your wife sitting like 4 feet from you.
Yeah, wasn't it when I walked in the door and I go, Brad, I'm home.
Oh, yeah. Where's
my coffee?
Yeah.
So when my pizza arrived at the door for lunch today.
Oh, my God.
Listen, sometimes that's
all it takes.
That was wonderful.
That's a good time.
I was very excited about that.
First bite of Domino's.
Yeah.
Scolding the mouth.
I also had a chicken ranch bacon sandwich with it.
Oh, my God.
You had pizza and a sandwich?
Yeah, I love my life.
Brad.
I mean, I love my wife. I'm going to say my Domino's was the highlight.
Listen, comfort food is no joke.
Dear heavens.
It's no joke.
Okay, so Brad's not going to dinner.
Probably still going to do that.
Well, good. So everyone had a moment that they could identify in their day that brought them joy.
Yeah. Well, what about you, Elly?
Yeah.
Me? So I had responsibilities to do today. I had to go out. I had to pay bills. I had to go grocery shopping, which I normally hate grocery shopping. I went at like 8 o'clock this morning and it was very peaceful.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Much better.
That wasn't the highlight of my day though. My highlight of the day was after all my adult responsibilities were done, I went to the beach and I sat on the beach with a little twisted tea, got a little sun. It was fun.
Nice.
I about died walking back though. It was so goddamn hot outside.
It's warm.
Woo.
It was a lovely beach day though.
It was beautiful. It was gorgeous out. But yeah, that was the highlight of my day.
Very nice.
But so the point of that is you should at the end of the day be able to pick a moment that you enjoyed in your day. No matter how rough it was, there's got to be a moment that you allow yourself to sit down and be like, that was good. I felt good. That made me happy. Because you have to enjoy your life. If you're not enjoying your life, you're doing it wrong. You're doing it wrong, especially if you have to fight for a life that you enjoy. You know, if you feel like you're constantly in a struggle, and you're fighting every day to find balance or success or happiness or just to get where you want to be. If you're fighting, you have to find those moments that are worth fighting for and find it in every single day. That's going to be those little stepping stones to get you to the end goal. And if you have to sit down and really think about it to find that moment every day, I encourage you to do that because it reminds you of the little things that you got going on in your life. It reminds you of the people and things that mean the most to you in your life. And that's something that's always good to reflect on at the end of the day. It's good to reflect on in the beginning of your day, too. You can start your day out that way. But yeah, if you're fighting to have a better life, don't forget that the life you're living that day is also good.
Yeah. Nice. I agree. I agree because, you know, like, it's okay to strive and it's okay to, I'm picklebacking, by the way. It's okay to strive and it's okay to,
you want a pickleback?
To work hard and hustle and grind and all those words that they throw at you to, you know, that make you seem successful. But the truth is, you only get today one go around and then it's gone. So if you're not finding joy in at least a moment of it, you're doing it wrong, just like you said. Mm-hmm. So you got to, I agree, you got to stop and smell the roses and all those other things that people say. It's wildly important.
It helps keep you focused. Keeps you focused on the right things.
Yeah.
Because you can have a bad day, and if you only focus on all the things that went wrong that day, your day's not going to get any better. But if you stop and you focus, you're like, this shit happened, this sucks, but I had a pretty good time when I did this today. So it's not all bad. Not all is lost.
Complete loss, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, and I think as human beings, we tend to focus on, it's easier to, I don't know what the word is, but obsess over the negative. The negatives stand out more than the positives, just,
oh yeah,
you know. So it's important to bring light to the positives, because it's not that bad. Life isn't that bad. Get over yourself. No, I'm just kidding. But
she calls it like she sees it.
Like, you know, it's easier to focus on the negative. So that's true. If you take a moment to just think, this is positive, that was good today, I did this, that happened, something has to be good, even if it's just eating your pizza,
literally, you know? Yeah. You took a hot shower where you were alone for 5 minutes.
Yeah, you sat on the couch for 2 seconds.
Yeah,
you drove around the neighborhood, whatever it is. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, and along the same lines, you can also look for a positive in the quote-unquote negatives.
True.
And count it all joy.
Yeah, silver linings.
There is a silver lining in, I had a bad day today, but I learned a lot.
Yep.
So it's not going to happen to me again. I know how to now move past that and make sure that the things that made today rough don't happen again. Yep. So while getting off work and being able to see you guys and hang out with you guys was the best part of my day, the rest of it really wasn't that bad in perspective.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. There's days I've had at work, or just in life in general, you know, and it's just like, this shit sucks. But also sometimes going through that, and then when it's done, you look back and you're like, you know what? I did exactly what I needed to do in that situation. And I did the best I could, and it's over, and we're here, and
I survived.
I survived. Hell yeah.
Yep. And you get to try again tomorrow. Literally.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice.
I mean,
but being able to try again tomorrow is something to be joyful about as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're afforded the opportunity to wake up tomorrow and try it again.
Hopefully.
If we're lucky.
Yeah. Yeah.
Brad pointed it out a couple weeks ago. I was wearing a shirt and it says, all of my scars are just when life was trying to keep me down but failed. Don't let life keep you down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a choice. It is a choice. You can choose to focus on the negative, or you can choose to find one thing a day that brings you joy.
Yep.
And I highly recommend you find one thing that brings you joy.
Yeah.
Your life will significantly improve. And when you focus on the good things, more good things, you'll see more good things in your life. You'll stop seeing so many bad things.
Yeah. Love it.
True.
Love it.
Yeah, I like it.
Great job, Elly.
Nice. Glad well Elly. Done. Thank once you. I got there she is.
Every time she walks in that door, she pinks out.
Those pink sunglasses.
Even though I look like death.
Yeah. But you got that pop of pink on the head. Yeah.
Jaybird said, good job, Elly.
Oh, thanks.
You lovely little troublemaker. He said,
in air quotes.
That's a song off of Brad Brock album. Did you know that?
Go figure.
Sure is.
But not the very old album.
No. This is the sophomore.
The second,
release.
The middle child.
Yes. All right, you guys. We're going to go around the room and hit you with our shameless. Look out. All right, anybody want to kick it off?
I do.
All right. Oh, God. No, you're cut off.
Yeah,
you
no,
no more. Shut
no.
off.
No.
He's like, no, I have a legit no. one this week.
This Friday, live streaming from Revenge Rum in West Palm Beach. You guys can check Paul from the Drums and Rums podcast. He will be there. You can go see him live at Revenge Rum, or you can join him online. It is going from 5 o'clock till 8 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time, obviously. If you are not watching live, that is on Friday, August 4th, 2023. Yeah, that's crazy.
Where is Revenge Rum?
In West Palm Beach, oh. If you would listen to what I'm saying.
I was very... And what time again? I'm sorry.
From 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. You can, like I said, you can join them live at the event, or you can join them online and watch the live stream.
Cool.
Very good to know. Thank you, Derek.
Yeah.
That was an excellent shameless plug, Derek.
I do my best, my friend. Mm-hmm. So now let me continue.
No, anybody else?
Make sure you go see...
Make sure you go see
Kevin McLoughlin at his next show. I don't know where it's going to be, but you can look him up online. And
I know where it's going to be.
I didn't ask you.
I know where it's going to be. I'm going to touch
your face.
Oh,
this is my shameless plug. The whole show's been about you.
You've been silent.
This is not a song about you.
Or any other Brad.
No, I was just going to try to steal some of Brad's. But make sure you check out some of our sponsors. We got Code Rum over here.
Oh, God,
here make sure you see. Go hang out in downtown Stuart, Florida, and go to the Sneaky Tiki. If you want to get your drink on, make sure you go and see it. Look up our friends at Drizzly.
Drizzly.
Aha.
Drizzly.
That's how you do it, Brad.
That's how. Derek, it's your show now.
Look at me. I'm the host now.
That's a 2009 meme.
There you go.
I will throw it back to you, my friend.
Thank you. Anybody else have any shameless plugs?
Just in queso.
Oh, boy. Here we go.
The Just in Queso Foundation for Tijuana Flats. Come see us. You can sign up for our rewards app, too, which, by the way, if you guys don't have it, it's basically free stuff. So you should,
I got it.
Brad doesn't believe in those things.
Well,
that's because he's a little bitch.
Brad gets no free desserts.
He likes paying retail for everything. Yeah.
Oh, right.
Speaking of retail, you can buy some of our retail sauce bottles, and some of them, the proceeds do go to the Just In Queso Foundation. Our Jason's Mom sauce is usually one of those. Smack Sweet sauce, which is one of my favorites. That one also, we do a lot of promotions with it. Last month, I think it was the One Pulse Foundation was with our Smack Sweet sauce. But yeah, come check it out. Buy some hot sauce. Donate. Get some tacos. Yeah. Tijuana Flats and the Just In Queso Foundation.
Nice. How about you, Jordan? Any shameless plugs tonight?
No.
Okay.
No, thank you.
So I just want to explain to everybody listening that I might sound a little bit more harsh to Brad than I've been in the past. I promised somebody that because Brad said this show was going to be all about him, I was going to spend 2 to 2.5 hours of just ragging on him.
I already called Brad a walrus earlier, so.
She did.
You guys have done a great job.
We got to humble him a little bit.
Yeah, he's got to fit out of the room and into it.
It's okay because, you know, when my feelings are hurt, I just eat
grab
more.
Another pizza.
I just eat more zingers.
Spend more of Jordan's money.
Yeah,
right. Spend more of Jordan's money. That's somebody's got to spend it. Might as well be me. All right, I'm quickly going to run through my plugs. As Derek mentioned,
hair plugs?
The next place that the Kevin McLoughlin is performing is with me tomorrow night at the Square Grouper.
Derek, how'd you miss that one?
Yep, Kevin will be...
I never go to a Brad Brock show.
Kevin's filling in for the amazing Tony Solomon, who's out of town. So it's always nice to jam with friends, and so Kevin's going to be with me at the Square Grouper tomorrow, Thursday, August 3rd. If you're watching, not watching this live, you've missed it. we'll be there 8 to 11. So come and hang out with us there. Big shout out to our continued sponsors at partners at Code Rum, Hop Life Brewing, Paul from the Drums and Rums. Happy birthday, Paul. And so awesome for pulling in some local live music remotely for us tonight. That was just such a great thing to pull together last minute. I love that. And we made it work. So thank you, Paul. We love you, man.
Are you going to actually be at the Square Grouper tomorrow? Because last time I tried to go to a Brad Brock show, you didn't show.
Well, if it's pouring rain, not likely, but I'll be there. Otherwise I'll be there. Square Grouper they're hard pressed to cancel. They have pretty good coverage there, but yeah, I'll probably be there for sure. Okay,
good to know.
8 to 11.
You said tomorrow night?
Tomorrow night.
I might be there.
All right. Then we'll wind up at the jetty for some rum runners.
I won't be there.
You will be there.
I will be there.
You will?
Yes.
Anyway, great.
Someone has to watch else the we bugs got going the on?
The Sneaky Tiki in Downtown Stewart, the Heathers, who were our guests last night.
Last week.
Last week.
What were you doing last
week? I just black out the whole week until I get here. The Heathers, what a riot. Go and see them at the Sneaky Tiki on any given night. They're say a great time.
Darren, too.
And say hi to Darren. StuartGroove.com. We got some big things in the work there with Joe Neeson. We're going to put that together. But it's a great up-and-coming local entertainment calendar. So check it out now. Get in on the ground floor. StuartGroove.com. Shore Life Radio. We love you guys. All you waiters out there, we thank you for tuning in and listening to our show. If you're a Trop Rock Music Association member, go and vote for us Wednesday night live with jams and cocktails. If we get a trophy, I will hug the trophy for an entire month of our shows. If we win something, I will hold it with me.
Is that for the whole 30 show. Days worth of shows, or is that
4 weeks? Four weeks worth of shows. But I promise I'll sleep with it every single night.
Wow. Sorry, Jordan.
Jordan has no say.
She's like, we just got Abe Lincoln out of the bed. Come on.
Yeah.
Isn't that crazy? Hold on. Let's look again.
I could go find that photo above the computer screen.
Abe Lincoln.
I could go find so many things. It's kind of like that I Spy game.
I Spy. Yeah, there's a lot. There's a lot that still exists. I still think I have that floppy disk drive holder that's down there, too. I've got that. I'm sure I've got that that photo. Elly actually bought me that painting for Christmas one year.
You probably have that watch that's on your wrist.
No, and I think that's...
You don't have that hair, though.
No.
Oh.
You got that blade still, though.
Nice.
Got the blade.
I do have the blade.
He doesn't have that muscle anymore either.
Oh, that thing's gone too.
Oh, damn.
And the bug juice. Be sure to check out the bug juice as well. If you'd like to become a sponsor or partner of our show, reach out to us on our website, jnclive.tv. Go check out that website anyway. The truth is, my phone buzzes every time one of you goes to the website. I want it to just be vibrating all the time. It's crazy.
Get it out of your pants.
I won't do that. And of course, if you like what we do and just want to throw a little jingle our way, you can sign up for our Patreon page for $5 a month, and you get all the perks and lines out there. Do you shop on Amazon? Of course you do. Hit me up for our affiliate link, or so you can support our show while you shop, and the link will also be in the forever
upload.
Yeah, upload. Ashley said, wait, what website? JNCLive.tv, Ashley. I love you, Ashley. And of course, on Amazon, please click our affiliate link. Oh, where you vote. Ashley, I will send you a link to that. You're amazing. She's amazing. She helped me pick out Jordan's engagement ring and was at my wedding. Wonderful. And again, if you're watching this, come and see me tomorrow night at the Square Grouper. That's been it for my shameless.
Shameless hair plugs.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. There's going to be that. I'm not going to lie, you guys. Next week, probably going to be some changes to old Brad. Might have made an online purchase from Instagram.
Is it a wig?
No.
Just for me.
I might be just a bit darker. I might be just a little bit darker next week. Just say that. It's not a tanning thing. My hair, for God's sake, it's hair dye. I'm going to give it a shot. Listen, I would.
So you make your receding hairline more prominent?
Yes.
Okay.
I love you, Elly.
Yes. So I would probably dye my hair all the time. But the most available hair dye, of course, just for men at any department store or pharmacy or wherever you shop, it makes my skin itch. It's the worst.
Have you tried like professional hair dye? Like,
so the problem with professional hair dye,
he doesn't have enough hair.
Is, well, okay.
Yeah,
thank you,
and
Derek.
Brad doesn't realize there's semi-permanent hair dyes that aren't just for men that can rinse out.
So that's what
he
I got.
He thinks it stains forever. So, it grows out.
Okay.
There's colored conditioner you can get as well.
Okay. Well, I'm going to try with this product that's called Simpler. And people have rave reviews on it. So, well.
I have a question.
Oh, yeah, I probably don't have an answer, but let's listen.
Okay. Why would you worry about that when she already loves you the way you are?
Well, Derek, you probably answered your own question. If you're wondering why I'm dyeing my hair, maybe you should ask the source.
Oh.
Jordan doesn't like your gray bush?
Yeah, he'll be dyeing that too.
So, yeah.
Wait, is it gray?
I don't want to know.
Everything's gray, man. It's all gray.
Except for his back hair.
No, or his ass crack hair. We all saw that on 4th of July.
Yeah,
that was not gray.
That's good to know that some of it's not aging. I kind of wonder if it's a whole, like, getting, like, being in the sun. Because, like, you know, I wear a lot of hats. And you notice how it's, like, only gray at, like, the hat line down. And then it's still pretty dark on
and
top.
And your little chest.
And but like in the V, like where the sun would hit my chest is gray, but the rest of it's still pretty dark.
Is it?
That's I don't know. I don't examine. Jordan examines.
Savage.
Philip says the carpets match the drapes. Yep. So anyway, we're gonna give it a shot. A lot of the people in the reviews of this product say that it doesn't. It doesn't make their face itch. That was the big thing for me for dyeing my beard, was it made my face itch so bad. And this apparently doesn't do that. So we'll see. And I would have been doing it for ages, honestly. I just couldn't deal with all that. And it grows out very quickly. You have to keep doing it. Just for men. It's a cheap, very available product. If you need to get it done, go get it done. This is a little bit more expensive and takes a little longer to get to you. So we'll see. I'll check in. We'll check in next week and see how it goes. I don't know. I don't know when it's getting here.
What could go wrong?
What could possibly go wrong? All right, you guys. Well, let's wrap this thing up. Thank you guys so much for taking this trip down memory lane and all the other lanes that we went down tonight. I hope you enjoyed the ride. Give it up once again for the JNC Destruction Crew, Jordan, Elly, Derek, and Paul, an honorary JNC member, being a correspondent for us tonight. We love you guys. I'm so glad that we came together tonight. It's great to have you. Join us next week for another evening of shenanigans and dark hair. Until then, take care of yourselves and each other, and go stream Welcome to Hollywood on your favorite streaming platform. Broadcasting live from the legendary JNC Lounge, I'm Brad Brock. We love you. Here's one more tune, and this is Don't Cry, Elly, but this goes back to 2010, a live performance at a place called Swamp Grass Willie's. This is our version of Unrequited, And there were some lovely people in the audience for this one. Good night. We love you guys. Cheers.
I'm about to get some of my mind.